Hello there everyone, welcome back. Today I have something natural, something organic in mind. Geometry node based, Blender 4.0. We're using repeat zones, right? So what I have in mind is a flower, right? And that is what the repeat zone is perfect for, and I will show you exactly why as well. So let's get into that. So by default, I don't need the cube, but I won't just delete it, okay? Let's just add a little geometry node setup right there. Modifier, geometry nodes. There we go. And let's drag this to the... Oh my god, that's not the right direction. Let's drag this to the left is what I meant to say. There we go. Now in the geometry nodes editor, we can just create a new little geometry node setup, right? There we go. Now, just because we don't need the cube doesn't mean we have to delete it, right? We can just disconnect it and it will stay forever in our group input right here, unless we delete it in our viewport. So I don't need the cube, but I want to create a flower. So there's a few different segments that we need for that. Number one, we need a core of the flower, right? Something to spread the petals around and something to make the little, the pollen thingies, the little stringies from the core, right? And then we need the petals, of course, the leaves and the string, or the, what's it called? Like the strand on which flower is located. I know all the biological terms for flower, of course. I know it all. So let's start with the basics, right? And let's start with the hard part, which is making those petals, right? And making them nicely wrap around the core. So to do that, I'm going to start with the petal itself. And I'm going to hit Shift A. And I'm just going to first add, let's add a quadrilateral, quadratic bezier, right? Perfect. And there's a few ways to do this. And the first is to create a curve manually, right? If I connect this up here, we can completely customizable make this shape. But we could also make it in, well, in drawing the curve ourselves. But I don't think that's going to be the right approach here. So we're going to use this. And by default, I'm going to set everything here to 0. Just because I don't want to use the basic settings. I want to use 0. And then I want to give custom parameters pretty much, right? The shape of a petal. So I'm going to first extrude the middle part out a little bit in the X direction. Let's say 0.5. Or no, let's do 1. Let's work in units of 1, and let's do the end at 2, right? That means that our center point is in the middle there, and that means that if I now set my Z position of the end down, it's going to have a nice curvature, right? And we can even make it the middle position go up, and that depends on the shape of your petal, right? Really depends on what you're looking for. So I'm going to keep it something like this, I guess, for now. We could just change that later. That's the fun of geometry nodes. And so now we need some kind of a curvature right there as well, right? To give it some thickness. So how do we get this into our mesh? Well, we add a Shift A, curve to mesh. Curve to mesh. There we go. And the profile curve is going to be whatever we want it to be, right? And it has to be a curve, of course. But I'm going to set this as a curve line to start off, right? Now, the direction of the line is usually wrong. So let's set that to 0. Let's just see which direction we need. This is the wrong one as well. So we need the X direction, I guess. Let's not do everything. The X direction, right? So let's set this to 0.5 and the start to -0.5. There we go. And now we have a curve line that exists out of 2 points, a start and an end. And to create some kind of a organic shape, we need some more resolution. So we need to resample that curve. So resample curve. And let's just make that 10 by default. That's fine. Okay. So let's actually give this the radius that the start is going to be 0 and then goes out and then goes in again like a flower leaf. Right, so let's hit Shift A and set curve radius. There we go. And the radius, drag that out, is going to be dependent on the spline parameter of the factor, right? That means the start is 0 and the end is 1, which means that the radius at the start is now 0 and at the end it is now 1. All right, so if we want to control that, we can hit Shift A and find a float curve. And this float curve is now based on that factor. And it is still at the start 0 and at the end 1. And now we can actually just do some moving of that curve to make it exactly how we want it to be. Something like that. Now the resolution of your line depends. It doesn't depend, but it really indicates how tight those corners are gonna be, right? I can drag this up, and that's the wrong one. We need the actual quadratic Bezier curve to go up, right? You can see that it's getting smoother and smoother. Okay, so I recommend just setting that at 50, for example, right now, and we can change that once again later, right? So maybe not this tight at the start, because we will have to actually array that at some point as well. Let's make it something like this for now, right? So I think that looks quite interesting. Make it more curved, something like this perhaps. Yeah, why not, we can always change that later, like I said before. And this, I want this to be a bit more like that. Beautiful. All right, so if you want some kind of a curvature in this profile as well, right, for example up or down, we need to give our curve line a little bit of a curvature, because otherwise it's going to be straight no matter what, right? So how do we do that? Well, quite easy. We need Shift A, a set position node, and we want this offset to be dependent on a curve, right? So if I just drag this all down or up, you can see that our entire petal is basically going to move up and down. Well, the line is the curve line. So set that to 0 and drag out your offset to combine XYZ. This way we can independently select that Z value. And that's exactly what we need, right? So let's Ctrl Shift click on that line so we can actually see what is happening. So if I drag this down, you can see it is actually moving the entire curve. I don't want that to happen. So I'm going to drag this out to a spline parameter. There we go. And now we have 0 to 1. Which means the right point is going to move up with 1 meter. That's not what we want. So hit Shift A and find a float curve. Here we go. And now we can actually, well, do whatever we want. Now, if you want that center point to stay nicely at the center, we need those sides to go, let's see. We need the sides to go up like that and the center to go back to 0 like that. All right. And then you can actually just drag that into the position or the shape you want it to be in. Something like this, for example. So let's go back to our curve to mesh. And there we go. We actually do have a little curvature, I hope. Let's see. Maybe we need this to be a bit stronger after all. Or we have it in the wrong direction, which is also possible. So let's try Y. There we go. All right. So we can also flip that curvature around by adding Shift A, a math node, drag it into the bottom and set this to subtract and set the value to 0. There we go. Now we have it as a little inverse, right? Beautiful. I'm going to save this real quick as a flower chest. Why not? There we go. So now we have a petal shape and we can create something with that at any point, right? So if you want some kind of a curvature or something different in this direction, you can either try to do it through the quadratic Bezier curve, but it has its limits as well, right? So sometimes it's better to just Shift A and set position. Here we go. And then we want the offset to be a combined XYZ once again. Let me clean this up just a little bit. Here we go. Make some space. All right. Combine XYZ into the offset. Let's swap those around real quick. There we go. And that combine XYZ, I want that Z value to change to based on, you guessed it, the spline parameter once again, right? So drag that out, spline parameter. There we go. And Shift A, float curve. There we go. The end is going to be 0. That was fine. And now we can actually start, well, moving this around a little bit like we want, right? If you want that in the other direction, of course, we can hit Shift A, math, the same thing we just did, subtract, second slot 0, right? And then we can actually make this move down a little bit. Isn't that amazing, guys? So we can actually control the entire shape of this at the end as well. Beautiful. Now let's actually make this a group, all right? And we're gonna drag this to the left. We don't really need it, so everything that's connected here, select it, Control G, and let's exit this right away. Exit the group. So this is our node group of the petal, so call this petal. There we go. Right, so that has been part one of this tutorial. We have the petal ready. In the next one, we're creating the core, we're creating the array, the repeat zone that actually takes care of the nice flower head. Okay, thank you so much for watching. If you liked it, please leave a like, subscribe, or leave a comment perhaps. Any one of those will make me very happy. And thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Cheers.